Hey, I thought I'd do a project update for you. Just finished the final coats of this evening. This is a bowl, a tray, I don't know, personal valet, anything you want to call it, really. It's meant to sit on a table, and you come in the house, put your keys, wallet in it, etc. You could use it for candy, etc. You get the point. But I wanted to talk a little bit about the material it's made out of, how I finished it, and how I made this. So as you can see, we've got some purple heart in there. That's the purple piece sandwiched in between what would be mahogany, and then lastly, yellow hearts. And I think the yellow heart really pops with the mahogany. So I'd never worked with mahogany. I really like the grain pattern. I ordered some from Bell Forest Products, where this is not an endorsement of them. I don't get paid from them. But I like Bell Forest because you can go out there, look at the materials, you can order it, and they'll ship it right to you. You can even look at photos of the specific piece of wood that you're considering buying. But I bought, I don't know, 10 board feet of mahogany, and I really like the grain padding. It's got some real detail pieces to the grain pattern. Look inside there, if it's not too shiny. I thought that was very pretty. And it cuts very, very nicely. I find it to be very similar to cherry. It's got a buttery cut to it, but it does burn. So you gotta be careful with the speed of your blade or your bit. I had some burn inside here, and I was able to sand that out. We'll talk about that in a minute. So it's finished with two coats of tung oil, and then I like to use a cutting board wax on it. And I put that on, let it sit for about 20 minutes, and I buff it out. And it gives it a nice kind of shiny luster to it. But it's not too glossy, which is really what I like. Somebody said, and I agree, you want the piece to make people want to touch it, right? And that's how I feel that type of finish achieves that. So how did I make this? How did I get these pieces of wood? It is all the way through. Let me show you a prototype I built this weekend. So this is just poplar and masonite. And you can see it's three-quarter inch boards, very standard. I had it laying around. And the first step that you do in making this is think about it like a sandwich. You got two pieces of bread and you put something in between it. So in this case, it's masonite and the finished product, that was actually the purple heart there. So think about it like this, right? So you glue that up, let that sit overnight. I use Type Bond 3. I sometimes use the Gorilla Glue, I forget the name of it, but it's the type where you dampen the wood, you put the glue on, and then it will expand. And I use that for cutting boards a lot. I could have used that, maybe I should have used that for this, but I didn't. I just used Type Bond 3. Once that is set up, take it out of the clamps, and then what I did is I used the bandsaw. I drew a line right down the center of the board, the length of it, and I cut it on the bandsaw. So, you know, even going slow, you're not gonna have a perfect cut, right? So you've gotta take those two pieces, you've got two pieces now, and you gotta take it over to the joiner, which happens to be right here, and clean those up, right? So that you've got two perfect 90 degrees straight edges that then allows you to take whatever piece you're working or wanna put in there, in this case, yellow hearts. You put that in there, clamp that up, clamp side to side. A lot of pressure on there, right? Okay. Let that set up, clean that up, right? I used both a drum sander and I guess that's all I used was my drum sander. Cleaned up both sides, right? And now you've got this piece running through here and you've got this piece running through here, but now it's time to do this piece across the rip of it, right? So again, you've got a cut here. This time I did not use the bandsaw. I used my miter saw. My miter saw is very accurate, so I just lined the center line up in between the lasers and I cut that, right? And that now I can do two pieces here and I checked it. My miter saw is pretty accurate, so it was a perfect fit. I did not have to go to the joiner. But if your miter saw is a little off, make sure you go to the joiner, get that cleaned up. I had a lot of burning there, but it was fine. Put that piece in, and then glue or clamp from here to here, overnight, and now when it comes out, it looks like this. The only thing you want to be careful on is make sure that when you're gluing this piece and this piece, make sure these line up. Okay, you want to really pay attention to your lines, make sure they line up. I cleaned this one all the way up. You don't have to, but I mean, I thought it looked nice, so I cleaned it up. Imagine this now in this material, right? So you've got a square blank. This is 5 inches, so it's a little bit bigger, maybe 6 inches by 8 or 10. I took it to my my Shaper Origin, which is a handheld CNC machine. First, what I did is I drew a circle, an oval actually, on a CAD program called Graphic that is 5 inches by 8 inches. Saved it as an SVG, uploaded it to my my handheld CNC shaper, and that represents this outside line. And I cut that in increments of 0.1 of an inch. This is 1.75, so it's a lot of cuts, but you want to go slow. Let the bit do the work. And then I did an offset to get to the inside, right? And I think it was 0.4, okay? Let's look. Yep. 0.4 is the depth of this, right, or the thickness of this. Again, 0.10 offsets, 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, all the way down to 1.25 inches to get this shape. And then I use the half inch bit to pocket this out, and you have to go very slowly because that half inch bit wants to take off on you. So you gotta do very shallow, very slow movements, but I was able to get a fairly, it is perfectly symmetrical, right? Now when this comes out, I couldn't get to a full 1.78 inches, so I think I got to 1.6. Took it over to the bandsaw, cut it out, and then I took it to the orbital spindle sander from Rigid, and I cleaned up these edges. The outside's very easy. Just take your time, clean up the outside edges, right? It's the inside cuts that get tricky. So I actually used an attachable sanding drum that goes on your drill press or your handheld, in this case a drill press, and I just raised the bed up and I just worked it the inside here, right? Got that nice and smooth. Had some burn marks in here, so it took a little bit longer. This part is the hardest part because it's hard to get your hand in there. So that's just a lot of hand sanding, you know, 60 grit all the way up to 220 and even a little 400. So again, 2 coats of tung oil, cutting board wax, and it's just great to touch. So happy how this turned out. I think it looks good. I really like the yellow heart. Yellow heart is hard to find. The only place I see it is on Bell Forest. Purple heart you can get at Rockler. Mahogany you can get it around pretty easily. But I really like that contrast of the yellow to the mahogany. So hope you'll do something like this. At the very least, I hope you use this technique. I think it looks real nice. It adds a nice touch to your finished product, whether it's an oval, a circle, a square, etc. It's not hard to do. Just take your time, get your glue ups tight, and make sure your lines match up. So enjoy.